So hello, in this video I am going to discuss about some of the proton NMR questions of the organometallic compound which has come in previous NETS exam. So in particular that topic, the fluxionality topic is a very important. From that repeatedly questions coming from that fluxionality topic. So let's start with the first question, that is reaction of eta phi Cp Fe CO, that is this is CO minus with CH3Ig compound A. The proton NMR of A shows 2 signal in ratio of 3:5. Compound A on reacting with PPH3 give B. Proton NMR of B show 3 sets of signal in ratio 3:5:15. So we have to deduce which of the following structures of the product A and product B. So these are the option for product A and this is the option of the product B. So you have to choose the correct combination of product A and B. So this reaction I will write as FeCF5. I will denote as eta phi Cp as a Cp ligand. So this is CO2 and carrying negative charge, and when react with CH3I, since this complex carrying negative charge, so here methyl carrying positive charge and I minus carrying negative charge. So this negative charge can attack positive charge and it will attach to the metal and coordinate to metal. So what happened to that? It will form like Fe, Cp compound, CO, CO and CH3. Mean that charge get neutralized. If you compare with this given option, only option B contain this type of compound. If we see a proton NMR of this compound, it will be for phi, means phi signal from this Cp ligand, and three proton give one signal, so it will be 3:5 ratio, and five protons from give that Cp ligand, from the five proton give five one signal, so it will be 3:5. So this is number product A. The next option is what? It will react with PPH3. So if you count the total electron count, it will be from Cp it will be 5, from ion it will be 8, from 2 carbonyl it will be 2, 2, 4, and 1 methyl, so it will be 13, 4 is 17, and 1, 18, so it will be already 18 electron complex. So undergoing reaction with PPH3, it have to make one coordination site available for incoming PPH3 ligand. So what happened before reacting with PPH3? It undergo migratory insertion, means CO get migrate in between metal and methyl bond. So it will be look like FeCp CO CO CH3. So it becomes 16 electron complex. Next, then our PPH3 come and react with this complex, and it will get coordinated to Cp CO PPH3 CO. So proton NMR of this show signal intensity ratio 3 for methyl, 5 for Cp ligand, and 15 for PPH3, because PPH3 structure is like this. This is 3 phenyl group attached to phosphor, so each PH group contains C6H5, that is 5 proton, so multiplied by 3 it will be 15. So this is the structure of B and this is the structure of A. So correct option will be option number B. By looking only of the one of the product, you can directly check that this is the correct option, but there is a migratory insertion reaction also involved, so I have to give the information. I would like to give information about that also. So the correct option will be B. Next question is proton NMR of ruthenium eta 4 C8H8 at CO, that is CO3 ligand is attached, 3 carbonyl ligand, at 23 degree Celsius, consist of sharp single line. Number of signals observed at low temperature in its spectrum. So this is a cyclo-octa tetraene. It will be look like this. So this will be ruthenium, that is eta 4, means 4 carbon is attached to this. So this will be ruthenium and 3 carbonyl attached to this. So what is written? At 20 degree Celsius, it give only single line like this. So what happened? That ruthenium, if we label this, the label this carbon, I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. At 20 degree Celsius, it is equilibrium with this type of structure. Like say, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and remaining like 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and this is one of the. So this is like fluxionality in this complex. So what happened at one particular point, that 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon are attached to the ruthenium, and at the second, at a moment later, the ruthenium attached to another 4 carbon. So this will be at a room temperature around 23 degrees Celsius, structure change in between that. So it will give only one line. This is like, if you reduce the temperature to 140 degrees Celsius, your cyclooctatetraene will 1, 2, 3, 4 will become steep at particular structure. Let's look this structure. Means one of the structure get fixed at low temperature. So fluxional behavior can be detected at the fluxionality behavior can be shown at room temperature. This due to which that many line combine, it will give only one broad peak. If you lower the temperature, the fluxionality will be destroyed and you will get particular fixed rigid. The structure become rigid. So if you calculate, if you know the proton NMR, it will be, this is the A type proton, this is B, this is B, this is C, this is D, so this is D. So there are total 4 type of non-equivalent, 4 type of non-equivalent proton. So it give total 4 signal in proton NMR. So at low temperature, one of the structure become rigid, one of the structure you get at around 140 degrees Celsius, minus 140 degrees Celsius. So the correct answer will be 3. This is a example of fluxional behavior. Now next is eta 3 C3 MnCO3, show fluxional behavior. This is one of the question from fluxional behavior. Same proton NMR of this compound when it is non-fluxional state. So we have to show that at non-fluxional behavior, at low temperature, what will be it is given. So this is eta 3 alkyl complex is. So alkyl complex show fluxional behavior. So due to which you will get only one peak at room temperature. So if you decrease the temperature, it will be look like this. This is your eta 3 alkyl and here is Mn and CO, 4 carbonyl group. So how that your NMR will show peak from which of non-equivalent protons are. This is a one of the A type of proton. So there are two types of proton here, there. This is a, if I label, this will be proton. This is, these are the proton also. If you look simply say this is a, so it will give only two set, but not if this is case. So this is a proton, these two protons are near from this metal. So and these two proton are away from this metal. So you can show like the stereochemistry, it will be above the bond and it will be below the, like that. So this is a Ci indicate and this will be B. So there are total 3 non-equivalent proton will be there, and it will show intensity, how many protons of A type 1, how many proton of B type 2, and how many protons of C type 2. So it will be give 2:2:1. So option will be 3, signal with intensity ratio 2:2:1. So what happened in room temperature, it will get converted. Hb is interconverted to Sc, here also Hb interconverted to Sc. So you will get only two type of peak in this. Now let's see this compounded ion FeCp CO2 react with bromine to give A react with lithium aluminum hydride to give proton NMR of compound B consist of two signal with intensity ratio 5:1, compound B, compound A and compound B. So this is nothing but I discussed that June 2018 question, same compound given here. So that is Cp Fe, I can write as CO2 minus Br positive. So what happen, it will attack that positive type of Br means, and it will get Cp FeCO2 Br. So now next step what happen, that is lithium aluminum hydride. So this lithium aluminum hydride give H minus. So that lithium aluminum hydride give hydride, and this hydride will replace that bromine, and it will give as H minus. So that proton NMR, that phi intensity ratio of phi is come from the CP ligand, and one come from the proton, one come from the metal, which is act as hydride. This is CP, this is CO, this is H. So phi is 2, 1, that is phi, and this is 1. So it will be upfield signal, and this will be very downfield, means it comes negative ppm. So correct option will be answer A. So one of the way, when that this compound react with bromine, it get one add up bromine molecule, bromine atom, and next step what happened, the bromine replaced by the hydride, because that lithium aluminum hydride give hydride. So next is proton NMR of CP ruthenium C2, means two ethylene molecule attached at minus 20 degrees show signal of A type AX. This type of, they are given pattern in this olefinic region on increasing temperature to 70 degrees, not minus, about 70 degrees Celsius, separate line collapse into single line, which is due to, if you draw this I have written in ruthenium, this is rhodium is attached here also, rhodium is attached to 2 eta 2 alkyne ligand. So what happened generally in case of to increase that back bonding, that is metal to ligand type of bonding, it will show this type of structure like this. So what happened in this carbon is hybridized is sp2, while in this case your carbon is sp3. So this is a fluxionality in the alkyne ligand, that is carbon gets converted in hybridized state, that is sp2 converted into sp3, sp2 converted into sp3. So for becoming this, there should be rotation about that carbon, that is metal olefin bond, because no rotation will happen, then the hybridization fluxionality will not occur. So correct option will be free rotation of ethylene ligand about metal olefin bond. So you can see that here it is eta 2 complex, here also metal is attached to both the carbon at the same time, here also same time, but what is the chain between that, their hybridization state change, that is a sp3, because a single bond is there, here also single bond, but here double bond is there. So what happened in sp3 state, the hydrogen gets bends slight to increase the back bonding, structural change will happen. So this is the correct reason, that is free rotation of ethylene ligand about metal ligand, metal olefin bond. Intramolecular exchange between ethylene ligand, no. Intermolecular exchange between ethylene ligand, no. Change in heptacity of CP, no. Because only that you have seen AA pattern, XS pattern due to that this is, but as that temperature increases, the fluxionality become predominant, and you get only single peak. So correct option will be A. Next, this is come from 4 mark, December 2016. Treatment of FeCO5, means Fe pentacarbonyl with 1,3-butadiene gives B compound that show 2 signal of proton NMR. B on treatment with HCl yield compound C, which show 4 signal. We have to show the structure, correct structure of compound C. So this is given FeCO5, TBP geometry. So when react with 1,3-butadiene, this is a 18 electron complex ion, 8 into 5CO, that is 8 into 10, already 18 electron complex, so it is a stable. So in order to react with 1,3-butadiene, it will undergo dissociative substitution, means what happened, one of the means to make unsaturation, this is saturated compound, that is 18 electron saturated compound, 2 carbonyl group will be lost. So there will be what happen, Fe, it become CO, CO, NCO, and then come your butadiene. This is look like this. So this is eta 2, this is eta 2. Let's count the electron. Ion 8 into 3 carbonyl, that is 6, 2 2, that is 4. So it become 18 electron complex. To react with particular one molecule of butadiene, we have to remove two carbonyl, that is 2 carbon monoxide molecule, because 2 carbon monoxide molecule contribute 4 electron, as well as if a metal is attached like this manner. So this is eta 2, eta 2, it give 4 electron contribution. So that metal, that complex undergo removal of 2 carbon, it will get unsaturated, means 14 electron complex, means your 18 electron get complex converted into 14 electron complex, then it again converted to 18 electron complex by attaching with butadiene. So what happened in next step, that is, this is your compound number B, that is 18 electron complex, that is FeCO. Fe'll attach with eta 2, eta 2, and 3 carbonyl. What is next? That's it, proton NMR on reacted, treated with HCl. So it reacted with HCl. So what happened? It will remain look like this. Your CO will be there. Your CO will be there. Your CO will be there. And if you want to add HCl or H plus or Cl minus, you have to change the heptacity of this complex, because it can convert it, it can get added to HCl, but it undergo same type of process from 18 to maybe 14 or 16, means unsaturation means vacant coordinated site should be created. So what happened first? So in this, the heptacity of the ion will be changed from eta 2 to eta 3. If you count the eta 3 complex of this electron count, it will become 8 plus 6 plus 3, 17 electron. So when that HCl reacted chlorine will get added, H is added. So in question, what is given? Compound C show 4 signal in proton NMR. The 4 signal come from the, this is one carbon, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. So all the 4 carbon are non-equivalent. So the proton become 4 non-equivalent. So that's eta 3 complex give 4 type of proton signal, non-equivalent proton. If hydrogen is attached to the metal, it will give total 5 signal. So in answer, what is given? That it show only 4 signal. So correct option will be, that is eta 3 and chlorine is attached to here. So it will be correct option will be B. So this is the sum of the question. I like to mention in this, that is, I will discuss six question total, along with fluxional nature of that particular compound. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.